You know, I have a good feeling about this match. You know, I think we're things are going to be good. Good feeling. Oh, Dimir Gilgate, never mind, can't win. I jinx myself. Totally jinx myself. I think you get black because then like you need the two black to transmute Shred Memory. Is this getting countered? Nope. Alright, time to sculpt the perfect hand somehow. Yep. Teachings Control. We're just playing against all the decks that I've been battling with for you guys on previous Channel Fireball videos. Discard this and this. No land though, that's a little bit unfortunate. Oh, the double AK. So good. Careful study. Okay, this is something else. Wait. This is not a typical card you want in a control deck. Is this like a blue-black reanimator deck? No, take inventory. Holy. Just all the card draw on the planet. I like it. I mean, that means my opponent has to be playing four of each of these cards. Wow. So many cards. We just need an Exhume. All right, let's quote unquote go off here. Just kidding. I was just kidding. I'm doing this again because I know my opponent's gonna like try to mana screw me. Yeah. Whoa. Not really sure what that was about. Okay. Let's play Faithless Looting. Discard some of these. Play this. Our goal here is to try to sculpt the perfect hand. My opponent has not found a teaching yet, which is nice. All right, there we go. There's our threat. There's our threat. Are you going to counter my insolent neonate? Oh my goodness. That's an aggressive counterspell. I guess when you have teachings, it doesn't matter. I'm a little jealous of all this value. Well, Well, there is the exhume. Duress you. Deprive. Let's do this. Cast Tormenting Voice. Discard Dragon Breath. And this is surely going to resolve. There's just no way this doesn't resolve or gets dealt with in any number of different ways. God, we're trying, folks. We are trying. Pristine Talisman. This is a Pristine Talisman. Oh, Curse of the Bloody Tome. Okay. I think my best hope here is just to just keep jamming. I feel like it's just almost unwinnable. Once you get to this point, like, you need, like... Yeah, I'm just gonna concede here. Crypt Incursion 2? Yeah. Alright, so... I think we're gonna board a very similar way here to the other matchup. You know, the one good thing, though, at least for this matchup, is that the opponent has, like, no pressure. So I can just bring these in. Take out the Lightning Axes. And then, yeah. Let's try that. Let's do it. All right, well, this is it. You know, this is, like, this is the nuts. You know, hope our opponent doesn't have a turn one duress. My opponent had a turn one duress. Man, just had to ruin all of the fun. My opponent basically just ruined Christmas, you know? Alright, whatever. Let's attack, and then... I think it's so unrealistic to draw the Exhume that I might want to just keep... But the thing is, like, I don't know if I can realistically just kill them with Insulinia in it. Maybe it's just better to cast Faithless Looting. Crusher and Needle, sure. Take inventory. All right. Let's attack. One at a time. One at a time. I don't really need to dredge any more cards, so... I think we'll just do that. We're on the kill you with a bunch of crappy little creature strategy. Although, I guess I could have kept the Dragon's Breath. I don't know. Oh no! Well, That's why we have just the answer here. Oh no, the spell bomb. Alright. Alright. Plan B. Plan B. There should be like a man plan in the sideboard when people start bringing in all this anti-graveyard stuff. Alright, my opponent wants to hit land drops here. And missed. Yeah. You know, what I really wanted to see was just a bunch of random green creature decks. Not gonna lie. Decks that, like, you know, have very little in the form of, you know, interaction. All these super interactive, like, blue... Well, let's see, two losses to blue control decks. I guess we lost our burn deck, too. Although, had we had this same draw against the burn deck, I think we would have won very easily with the turn to Exhume, but... Careful Study is an interesting card to have. I guess if you're also playing Take Inventories... To be able to like filter through them early, because you don't really want to cast these early. So if you can like discard Take Inventory and then make it so that the later inventories you cast draw more cards, seems decent. But at the same time, this might be too much card draw, like too much do nothing. I mean, feel like I just need to run it out there and then try to rebuild. I mean, it's not like my opponent has six cards in hand and we have all lands. I'm just playing out my lands because if I draw an Ulamog Crusher, I can just play it next turn. Oh yes, we did it. We truly did it. This is getting counterspelled. No? Rookie mistake. Forbidden Alchemy? God. This deck is all card draw. I'm just curious, like, how much removal actually is in this deck. Might just be just Doomblades, because generally these teachings decks have a ton of cheap interactive removal, because you do get run over by aggressive decks, and I imagine this deck is probably very weak against those decks. Alright, I don't think we need to play any more lands. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Eh. This allows us to, like, play Duress into Crusher, maybe? Maybe my opponent decks. Look, we have to find... Some crazy land to come back from this. Oh man. Oh, God. Uh. Yeah. All right. Well, wish I had a cabal therapy. Well, you know what I accidentally did once in the Community Super League is I boarded out all of my win conditions. I boarded out all of my win conditions and I ended up conceding because of that. So maybe my opponent's in that same spot. But this looks like it's an Evan Justice. With the counterspell backup. I took the counterspell because my opponent already has a way to stop my graveyard. So I figure take the counterspell and somehow fight through all of them. I'm gonna do something a little bit. I thought my opponent would count. I was hoping my opponent would counter it. Yeah. Not exactly sure how we're supposed to come back from this. Ooh, that's something. Let's hope my opponent goes for the Evan Justice here, and then we might be able to resolve this actually. Accumulated knowledge. I don't even know how many there are in the yard. Two. Okay. Hey, my opponent's at 21 cards. Oh, here's the curse. Darn. Get in there. Seven, eight mana. Okay. Draw four cards off AK. My opponent still has counter magic, so like I can't really pyroblast a curse here. Not really sure when or how I'm supposed to fire this off, but I guess at this point I play the Crusher just to get it countered. So let's, yeah, go ahead and attack. There you go. Crush! Oh, had a counter, how lucky. So three counter spells. Yeah, I'm trying to figure out a way how I'm supposed, like, I'm trying to figure out a way to get this curse somehow. I do have a lot of pyroblasts. Although, how many do I have left in my deck? I have two left in my deck. Alright, we drew another crusher. Crush. So how many counter spells have they cast? Three? So that's now four. There's a teachings in the yard. I think like they can still have like a dispel or something, so I'm gonna try to find a duress here. This neonate's not gonna get us there. Okay. Ooh. Oh wait. Okay. Okay. I don't think this is gonna happen. I have seven lands in play too. Life. Yeah, basically just like trying to get my opponent to use their deprive or something. Or I just want to see my opponent's hand. We'll let this resolve. Negate, okay. Alright, so I think my opponent could have dispel. I don't know how many they would bring in, but this seems like the time to go for the pyroblast. I guess I can act, well, no. Actually, let me think. Okay, sure. Yeah. Let's go for it. Here's the hoping. Very unlikely to resolve. Yep, this is a deprive. I tried. We tried, folks. We tried so hard. Too many counter spells, too much card draw. We're gonna go down to 12 cards. I guess my opponent can also try going with the Evankar's Justice strategy here. Do we want to discard the last rites? Sure. Kind of want to find a pyroblast, so it'll dig us one card deeper. Whoa. Eight cards left in their deck. All right, I need to just draw pyroblast. We've gone through two of them. Power Blast. Alright, now my opponent's up a card, which is unfortunate. We milled a Pyroblast. Okay, so we have, how many Pyroblasts in my yard? One, two, three. Oh my god, two Hydroblast too? Alright. These blue control decks are way too hard to beat as a Reanimator deck. Alright, well, there you have it, folks. Not a great finish with the deck, but, you know, the deck's kind of sweet. You know, it's just like if you're tired of all the same old boring decks, you know, your mono blue decks, your blue-black control decks, you can certainly try this. Now, this deck, I think, does have good matchups. I think we just ended up running into some of the more difficult ones. I think Burn might be a little bit closer, but creature matchups, you know, decks like Boggles, maybe even Elves, don't seem like the worst matchups, because they have less ways to kind of interact with you, but the decks with the milling counterspells are really, really hard. I'm also not sure how this deck matches up against, like, the Tron combo decks, for example, because they do have a little less, they do tend to have less counter magic. So it might be easier to kind of fight through those decks as well. But I mean, this deck is still kind of fun. Once again, just kind of a new approach. Personally, you know, I like playing the blue-black control decks. But again, we got to do some cool things. You know, for example, when we played against, like, the Boggles deck. The Boggles deck, they just really had not a whole lot they could do. And the Ulamog Crusher went all the way. But there's a lot of black removal decks that can just kill Ulamog Crusher at instant speed. And yeah, certainly not as powerful as Reanimator decks. You know, animating Ulamog Crusher, not quite the same effect as animating a Gristlebrand. But we're playing Pauper, and this is what we have access to. But anyways, thank you all for watching. There's not a whole lot of Magic Online right now, so I thought this was an excellent week to try to showcase something different. And the next week, I believe Cube Drafts are going to be available. So I might be running some of those once it's out. So thank you for watching, and I will see you all next week.